I'm very sensitive to people when they look at me, and I can tell if there's acceptance or rejection. I've always been different bodied. In my case, giantess, also dubbed as a strong woman. I try to filter out things, and I try to be an accepting and loving person back to them, regardless of their opinion or attitude towards me. It's not always easy. There's still a lot of criticism and a lot of hate that's still out there towards transgender people. I can only control what's in here. I can't control someone else.
You're a good man, Jimmy. You're only trying to help.
My name is Erika Ervin, and I play Amazon Eve in American Horror Story Freak Show. The part was originally slated for man. I auditioned for the part as a guy, slicked back my hair, no makeup, flannel shirt, bound my breasts, dropped my voice, and walked in and nailed it. The story itself is taking me on my own personal journey and seeing where I personally fit in this paradigm called freak show. I've kind of lived my life in hiding. My first inkling of knowing that I was different, I was about 4 or 5. It was an issue of gender. And that's when I was looking in the mirror when I was young, and I would push my penis between my legs, and I would look and I said, that looks right. It's not until later on that I discovered there was a way to fix it. And I made plans, and by the time I was 16, I moved to the Bay Area. There was this strange disease. It didn't have a name, it was AIDS. But it put a lot of fear in me. And for me to explore who I am, I'd have to go into the gay community. I'd have to explore who I was. I hid. I went to college for a lot of years. I spent about 15 years in school, and I just didn't want to come out. My mother was a nurse, and she died of AIDS in 1990. This is before they had the safety needles. You know, she was giving a patient an injection, and she pricked herself. That's affected my life.
Asshole! Come down to my base!
All right, let's go.
Yes, I am single. I have dated quite a bit. In about 2004, I came out as transgender. And my family literally wrote back and says, do not write, do not call, you're no longer welcome in our home. Wow. My father and I don't get along very well. My father was very strict. He was a high school science teacher when he retired, and I would like to, at the very least, have him see me make it on camera, make it on TV and film.
Perhaps you need reminding that we are a troupe, a family. The whole gestalt is greater than the sum of our parts.
There's two things you need to study in life, law and kung fu. I went to law school, and I had aspirations of being an attorney. It's a promise I made to my mother. And from sitting on my butt for long hours in a law office, I got out of shape, and I started going to the gym and working out. In that same time, I was also dealing with gender. Now, there's a lot of pressure that women are placed under to be small and weak. I'm stronger just because I'm bigger. I know I'm not the first. I'm moving forward. I'm moving onward. I'm not used to the word hero or trailblazer. I don't feel like I'm anything other than female. I think the transgender movement could actually learn from the freak narrative. The narrative of extraordinary bodies, differences, celebrating our differences. It's a place for people who are different to come together and find a sense of community. It's more than just a freak show. There's a family here.